Everything produces energy, and energy travels in waves, which means at this point, you are projecting energy, I am projecting energy, your house is projecting energy, the car is projecting energy, the earth has energy coming away from it, and the sun has energy coming away from it. Everything continues to produce energy in waves unless it reaches what's called zero Kelvin, which is minus 273 Celsius or minus 459 degrees Fahrenheit. That means that what happens is the molecules literally stop moving. And when they stop moving, they stop producing energy. But on Earth, nothing exists like that naturally. It can only be done in a laboratory. The hotter something is, the shorter the wavelengths are that it produces. So in other words, something like this, I know this is a little goofy, but you can see that the wavelengths are pushed close together. And the cooler something is, the longer the wavelengths are that it produces. So again, you know, I'm just trying to give you an example. This is not really what it looks like, but it's something like this. So the hotter something is, the shorter the wavelengths are that it produces. And the cooler something is, the longer the wavelengths are that it produces. For our purposes, there are only going to be two sources for energy. So we're not going to look at every single thing and what kind of energy spectrum it produces. We're only going to look at two things. And since this is an earth science class, guess what? The sun and the earth. Solar radiation is also known as shortwave radiation because the sun is hot. And the hotter something is, the shorter the spectrum it's going to produce. Whereas terrestrial, which means earth, radiation is long-wave radiation, because obviously the Earth is not as hot as the Sun. This is the way we're going to look at it. We're going to refer to solar radiation as short-wave radiation. We're going to refer to Earth radiation as long-wave radiation. Okay? Let's see how this is related to the Earth. It's really an incredible system when you start thinking about it. The gases that make up our atmosphere are not good at absorbing shortwave radiation. That means solar radiation does not actually heat us directly, at least not in terms of what you feel when you step outside and you feel heat in the air. The atmospheric gases, however, are excellent at absorbing long waves. And the surface of the Earth radiates long waves. Because of this, we are actually heated from below. Shortwave radiation comes in, passes through the atmospheric gases, which are not good at absorbing that shortwave radiation. They don't get heated up. And then they hit the surface of the planet. The surface of the planet, of course, is not an atmospheric gas. It's made of different things. And those things are good at absorbing shortwave radiation. And when they absorb that shortwave radiation, they're absorbing heat energy. And when they absorb that heat energy, they then in turn let out energy. Now, of course, the surface of the planet doesn't get as hot as the sun, so the surface of the planet does not produce a shortwave spectrum. It produces longwave radiation. And the nature of some of the gases of our atmosphere is such that, do you remember I told you that when you go around the backside of the Earth, if it wasn't for the gases, what would happen? That we would freeze solid? The nature of the gases, some of them, is that they're very good at absorbing long-wave radiation. Everybody's experienced this. If you look at the diagram on the left-hand side, here's what happens. You park your car out in the sun, and then you come back a couple hours later, and what happens? Yes, what happens is it's blazing on the inside. In a way, your car is acting somewhat like the way the atmosphere works. The shortwave radiation goes through the glass. It hits the objects on the inside, the dashboard, the steering wheel, your seat. If you have shorts on, you know this. You open up the door, you feel this wave of heat energy coming out. You sit on the seat and you burn. And you touch your hands onto the steering wheel and you burn. Well, what's going on is those objects let out long waves. And in a way, like the atmosphere, your windshield does not allow most of those long waves to get out. And so there's a concentration and building up of energy, which means, like you see on the right-hand side, park your car in the sun when it's 80 degrees outside, and 10 minutes later, the interior of the car is 99 because all of that energy is coming in, it's being absorbed by the things that are inside the car, the solid objects in the car. They let out long waves, and then those long waves are not able to escape. That allows things to heat up inside the car. Take a look at this diagram. So this is more, I guess, of a scientific diagram. Shortwave radiation comes in from the sun. As we know, it's reflected, it's absorbed, and it's scattered by the atmosphere, but 47% of it reaches the surface. That shortwave radiation, when it comes down and reaches the surface, heats the surface. When it heats the surface then lets out long waves, and these atmospheric gases are good at absorbing the long waves. Do you remember when I asked you about the pot of water and what was heating the water? Was it the flame? No. In this case, the flame is the sun. What was heating the water? The pot. In this case, the water is the atmosphere and the pot is the surface of the planet. So yes, without the sun, we're done. That rhymed. Without the sun, we're done. But of course, the sun is not the thing that's really heating us when we feel heat outside. And it's not the thing that's keeping us alive at night when we go around the backside. It is the atmosphere that has absorbed long-wave radiation and stored that long-wave radiation. What I just described to you has a name. It's called the greenhouse effect, which is the heating of the atmosphere based largely on the fact that shortwave radiation easily penetrates the atmosphere while long-wave radiation is absorbed, thus raising temperatures. Now, the greenhouse effect is completely natural. It's normal. We have to have this in order to survive. This is the thing that keeps us alive at night when we go around the backside so that we don't drop by 400 degrees and freeze solid. The question over the last several decades has been about an accelerated greenhouse effect. When you step on the accelerator on your car, what happens? You go faster. That's what it means. An increase in the ability of the greenhouse effect to be operating. This is what has led to global warming, also known as global climate change.